This is Minneapolis, Minnesota. This is the Spoon Bridge and Cherry Sculpture. This is where Tim Gay Johnson and Howard Dwight Taft lived. Tim and Howard were together for 30 years. They lived in Minneapolis, Minnesota. Tim was famous for three things. His floral arrangements were truly extraordinary. He donated a lot of money to politics. He had quite something down there. What was Howie only famous for? His relationship with Tim. They had an open relationship. Men wanted Tim because of his... Did men want Howie? Not really. He was just average down there. Then Tim suddenly died, leaving Howie behind to deal with the chaos of grief and the confusions of dating, especially when he was just a nobody. How does such a guy date? All this happens in the year of 2008. Does my novel follow only Howie? Oh no. My book truly follows three characters. Howie, of course, Betsy, and Nick. Howie works as a bookkeeper for a flower distributor. Betsy is a transgender embalmer and a legendary MC at the Gay 90s bar in downtown Minneapolis. Nick works in the same office as Howie. Betsy and Tim were best friends. Nick and Tim were pretty good friends. Betsy and Nick were both attracted to Howie because in a world of chaos and uncertainty, Howie was absolutely reliable, a solid rock. A sweet and sexy tale of a middle-aged man's fumbling, awkward, often uncomfortable but persistent search of the love he deserves, a story that lots of gay men of a certain age will connect with. Wayne Hoffman, author of An Older Man and Hard.